Hello.
Hey, this is your girl, Coco929, aka Libra Butterfly. I wanted to do first I want to say hello to all of my listeners, and prophetically, I wanted to do an update. So, I told you guys that, the day after the election, that, the presbyter that we have now would still be in office. Okay, that's true. I told you guys that I see several, how can I say it? I want to say that because YouTube is funny. They kind of censor you after a while. I see several expirations happening in the government. Okay. There will be some terms that's expired permanently out of the world, if you catch my drift. There will be, I also told y'all that I saw an entertainer passing away, and we see that was Sean Connery. I told y'all that I seen another sports figure, and I told you right around, I said it would be a whole lot of, it would be like a tornado right around election time, as well as the month of October would be like in turmoil. Things would be up and be down, it was sad and sad. The rest of this year, I told you October would be the beginning. The rest of this year is going to be like a topsy-turvy. Okay, remember I said that anything that can be shaken will be shaken. That's still in play. It's very important that we stay positive, speak positive, surround ourselves with positivity, with love, to raise our vibrations. It's very important that we do all of that, because that will help you stay a base. That will help you sail through. Okay. It's funny because tonight, once again, it came from the same person once again. Decided for whatever reason that they wanted to flip on me again, you know. And I laugh at it now. The last time it pissed me off, you know. But I laugh at it now because I don't expect nothing different. You know, it's nothing worse than grown people having tantrums. It's really nothing worse than grown people not being able to express what pissed them off, what makes them mad, what they don't like, you know, and all of that. So I realized that the more I get love, or the more the people love on me, this makes this person pissed, because they want to be the only person that I count on. And I count on me. I keep telling y'all what, I'm team what? Me. So that being said, I had to come to a conclusion that sometimes things is just not meant to be, you know? You can love people, you know, and everything is not sexual love, eros, okay? Some things is agape, some things is sisterly, you know, and all that and stuff. So, when I say love, you can love a person, but sometimes when the person don't really love themselves, they don't know how to love nobody else, you know? So, you have two options where that's concerned. You can deal with it. There are ups and downs, there are ups and downs, there are ups and downs, there are ups and downs. And hope that it does not pull you out of who you are and affect your life in a negative way. Or you can decide to let them have their ups and downs and ups and downs and ups and downs and ups and downs. And you stay focused on what you're supposed to do. And you embrace those that love you, that want to be a part of your life, that encourages you, that, you know, my sister is a real mama's real problems. Quiet Storm, It's All Hot Air, Miss Andrea Lynch, you know, that's the thing that we'd be talking about, is to embrace those that embrace you. You know, don't nobody have time for all that bootleg, I'm not sure who I am, and I'm mad because of this, and I can't say it, I'm pouting, or, you know, it's just ridiculous. I don't have the time. And even if I had time, that's not how I want to spend my time. What is my four things? I like to laugh, live, love, and I'm loyal. That's it. I love somebody who can make me laugh. I love somebody who, you know, that's loyal to me because I'm loyal to you. I love somebody who likes to live life, you know? And I love somebody who loves me, you know, no matter what, because I love hard. So, you know, lesson taught, lesson learned, it just is what it is. And I'm not, you know, once before, it upset me because I was like, you know, I'm sick of people telling me that they love me and they're there for me. But like I said, when I don't march the way they want me to, then they have an issue with me, and, you know, all this and stuff. And then they want you to be like, they want you to treat them like a baby. Like, what's wrong? Why are you acting like that? Well, they know dang well they really ain't got no reason to act like that. And even if they did, you verbalize. When you're an adult, you talk about it. You say, well, I'm mad, and this is why I'm mad. Or, I don't see, you know, whatever the case may be. Or, I'm hurt, I'm in pain, whatever the case may be. You know, I don't change no Pampers, no diapers, no Depends, none of that. You know, I don't change a grown person. I don't put a grown person on my shoulder and pat their back and belch them. I don't do none of that. You grown. Use your words. So I realize some people, you know, for me to expect people to change and they've been like it all their life, I'm like walking into a wall that ain't gonna move. Okay? It's like, you know, that's the easiest definition of being insane. You know, doing the same thing and expecting the different results. You know, with this particular person, it's the same thing. It's just the same exact thing. And then they, you know, say, well, they ain't gonna do it no more. They sorry. You know, and all this and stuff. But then they turn around and do it again. Now, either I'm done, or either that's an issue. And there's nothing about me that's dumb. That's an issue. And it's an issue that the person just don't want to face. So, you know, it is what it is. So, once again, Coco929, Libra Butterfly has lost a so-called friend. Whatever. Sorry. Not. Anyway, move forward. So, that being said, I'm taking applications. How about that? And, I am taking applications, and I have some sitting on my desk and some in my file cabinet. I would go in my file cabinet and take out the folder and, you know, look through the applications and see who's next, what's next, see who's qualified to step in the spot. Oh, my goodness, y'all. I am just there. And I had to make myself laugh for that because I swear people, they would, you know what's so funny? I believe this person right here loved to see me down. Like, if I'm down, they feel great. And I watch that. It's like I'm watching it. Every time I'm down, they happy. But once I'm, you know, laughing, or, you know, I'm talking about different people that's in my YouTube thing, it was in my chat, and I'm like, oh, and this person is, and this person is, you know, and oh, this person is, then it's an issue. They have no smile no more. They have nothing to say. Why? Because people showing me they love me. And you have an issue. I swear. By the moon and the stars in the sky. Anyway, I'll get it. I know my husband, he... Oh, my goodness. Mm-mm. Oh, y'all, guess what? And I forgot to tell y'all this. I got me some roses. I love flowers. He brought me 2 dozen roses. He surprised me. I came out of the office this morning and saw these roses sitting on our dining room table. I was like, ooh, what? And it just shocked me, you know, because anybody know me know I love flowers. I love candles. I love teddy bears. I love cards. I even love handwritten notes, like, you know, to wake up and something be stuck on the mirror up under my pillow that says, have a nice day. You know, something of that nature. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. So, I'm just excited. And, somebody I talked to today, I really don't know how to explain it. You know, this person never ceased to amaze me, you know, and they are necessary in my life, and at least in this season, you know. And I always tell y'all, and I always tell everybody that there are certain people that if I fall out with them, it's because we want to fall out, not because nobody else. And I was hurt when I thought something had happened, and it didn't happen the way that I thought, and that's why you shouldn't assume. And I was able to tell, you know, the person how I felt, and it's all good. And that's how adults handle stuff. They talk. Only a kid pouts, and I'm that's a Donald Trump syndrome. Y'all ain't never seen him do it. Somebody tried to talk to him, he pouts and folds his hands. I don't have nothing to say. No. I don't have nothing to say. You're like, would you grow up? Get out the tit already. You know, but that's developmental delay. A mental developmental delay. So, I'm just feeling good. And I wanted to come on and give y'all that update. About what's going on. And just be careful, y'all, because I will say this, and this is switching to back to the beginning. I will say this. There are people that are waiting to hear the news of a presidency because they want to cause havoc. They want to cause havoc. So be careful. Yeah, and those of you who knows the power of prayer, let me say this. Yeah, stop asking them to shut the United States down. You don't know what you're asking for when you say, just shut us down, because you're scared. You're speaking out of fear. Never speak out of fear, ever. You know, there was a United Kingdom's nurse who has a 94-year-old mother, and wanted to go get her mother and bring her mother out of the assisted living to live with her. They got locked up. She was locked up because she wanted to sign her mother out to come and stay with her during the quarantine. Got locked up. Okay? So, yeah, stop it. Ask God to help you with your fear. Those of you who walk around with a bunch of fear, and you know, don't speak that on me. And just because you're afraid, don't try to put me in bondage with you. You wear your mask. That's all you got to worry about is you, and that's what's wrong. Focus on what you do the right thing. And like, cause you know, don't you know, only 30% of air is circulating when you wear a mask. 30%. Some of us can't wear them, like myself. I have asthma. I can't wear them. And I don't wear it. Okay? So don't worry about me. You don't know what my conditions are that I can't wear a mask. You wear yours. Make sure you're protected. And you okay. How about that? So, you know. But anyway, y'all, I'm going to get out of here. I just wanted to come, like I said, and give an update and everything. And, oh, I don't know if he's going to hear this or not. I might have to text him. because I need him to help me with my computer. You know who you are. So I'll probably text you so you can walk me through what to do with this computer. Okay, y'all. Well, and I'm not mad at anybody. I'm not. I just, to that person, I just see you. I see you for what you are. And every time I say that, you get mad and you try to convince me otherwise. And then you end right back. And I just said that a week ago. I said, you're not going to do nothing but end right back up doing the same thing again. I'll be daggone. Here it is Friday. To thy own self be true. But, you know, I have no issue. I have no drama. I have nothing where you're concerned at all. I don't have no issue with it. You're cool. I just don't expect no more from you than what I get. That's it. That's it, subby. It's a sub, y'all. It's not a content creator. So, you know. You try to be there for people, and you try to go above and beyond. And I think people take your weakness for, or your kindness for a weakness. And then when you turn it off and you shut your valves of compassion, then they want to know what's wrong. You know, it's just crazy. It's crazy. And I don't have time to go up and down, up and down. Now, I told you, I need stability, you know. So, and that's what I have. And I just can't. And don't y'all let nobody take you out of your can till I can't, okay? I'm telling you. I'm warning you, keep your vibrations high, all right? Well, it's time for me to go. I'm going to make a call, and it's almost midnight, and I'm so glad I don't have to work tomorrow. They canceled our work for tomorrow. I'm so glad, but we do have to work next week. So, anyway, I love you guys, and remember, smooches.